Hello, welcome to Mowgli TV. Today we're going to talk about something that is one of those things that keeps cropping up through Reddit, Facebook, and all over the web, which is how to synchronize your visuals. This time, we're not going to talk about BPM sync. We're going to talk about sound reaction, or FFT as it's known within Resolume. Let's dive into it. So here we are in Resolume. The first thing you're going to need to do to set up your FFT is go to your preferences. And then if you go to your audio settings, you'll have to set up the relevant audio input device and external audio FFT input. So right now it says no input device. So if you are in a club environment, the most likely thing you're going to be using is the microphone. The microphone works pretty well, although there'll be some problems with background noise if you're in a very noisy environment or if you're really close to the bass bins, for example, you just get that rumble. But for a general use, in my experience, the microphone tends to work pretty well. It's a lot better if you get a feed straight from the DJ booth and you've got a sound card that you can connect that into. That will be a lot cleaner and it'll work a lot better, but it's not strictly necessary. And obviously there's loads of cases where that is simply not possible. So the most common setting will be your microphone. So you can just select your microphone in there and then you can go to your external audio FFT input and then select whichever the relevant option is for you. In my case, it'll be input channels 1 and 2, because I've got a stereo microphone built into my laptop. So that will be it. I've got to say that for the purpose of this tutorial, I'm not going to be using the microphone. I'm going to be using a sound clip that I've got here straight within Resolume, because it's actually not possible to record this tutorial while using a microphone input, because obviously there'll be the sound and then there's my voice and it's all coming from the outside. So for technical reason, I'm going to be using the audio clip that is on my file. But these are the settings that you need to use. So you select your microphone here and then you select your audio input and then your microphone in there. So now we can close that. Next, and this is a very handy thing to bear in mind, we've got the FFT gain and the representation of what is going on in there. You might not see this here. If you don't, you can go to your view menu and go to show FFT gain. Another very handy tip that you can do here is to actually MIDI map this knob, which not only allows you to adjust on the fly the level of the sound reaction as things might change. DJs do tend to ramp up the volume as the night progresses, so you might need to turn that down so that you don't get too much sound coming in. It's also a very handy performance tool, as you can actually switch the sound reaction on and off at the touch of a knob, which is extremely handy. You can have it switched off, and at some point, you can use that as an effect on its own, right? That you can actually control by switching on and off. Okay, so now for the actual usage of FFT. I've got some clips here from my VJ Pack Beta Gun, which is available on Gumroad. Link in the description. It's got this clip. What we can do here is, for example, add an effect to it. So let's go to our effects and find Bloom. We put it here and then we can adjust the parameters of Bloom so that it looks how we want it. So if we bring the threshold down and maybe the size up. So we've set it so you can see it's quite a dramatic effect if we switch it off. What we can do is play with the amount first. So you can see if this was reacting to the kick drum, for example, that would work quite nicely. So if we just go in here and you go to your amount, and then, as I was saying before, I'm going to be using the audio clip that I've got on my grid over here, but you'll probably be using a microphone. In that case, you should select external FFT. I'm going to select composition FFT because I'm using that clip, which is in the composition. So I'll select that. And now I can trigger this clip here. And if we go back to our clip, you can see this is usually close. So let's go to what you would see. That's what you would normally see. So that little arrow expands all these sound options here. So to start off with, you've got these three buttons here, which are lows, mids, and highs. As you can see, as I press, the bracket here moves across the spectrum, which is good to do this quickly, but it tends to be a lot better if you actually adjust this manually, so you can actually move the brackets and target the exact area that you want. So as you can see, that's reacting a lot better now with that beat going on. Other things to consider here are, well, the gain, which is quite self-explanatory. If I switch it all the way down, it doesn't react at all. If I switch it all the way up, it brings all the volume up a bit too much if you want to. You can use that creatively. This will have the same effect as I was saying earlier of mapping this FFT gain knob if you're using external FFT. So if you turn that on and off, you can have the sound reaction coming in and out as you want. Another setting here to bear in mind is the fall. Fall is how long it takes for that reaction that's gone up to go back down. So the shorter it is, the quicker it will be. So if I turn it all the way down, you can see that this is a lot more snappy. It's actually going from zero up and then back to zero in between beats. Well, if I put it here, it never reaches the zero point because it hadn't got time to get there before the next beat kicks in. So let's just tweak that, bring it down so it's quite snappy. Other things to consider here are, for example, these plus and minus buttons over here. If you click on plus, the amount will increase with every beat, which can be very useful. Let's have a look at that. So if we click this, go back to our clip. So that's going up and down. But if I click on up, you can see it keeps jumping through. Let's use that to create something that works a bit better, as that bloom effect is probably not the best to be shown that particular case. For example, if we go to our transform on the clip, we can make the scale go up with every hit of the drum. So let's start by setting the scale here to our composition FFT. So now it's in zero, so you won't see anything. So we need to bring this up to 100. So that's the minimum, 100% will be the minimum size. Now what we can do is expand the sound settings, click our audio, switch the plus. You can see how it's jumping. Let's again adjust the bracket, tweak our gain a bit maybe. And now if you bring the fall back down, it'll do a massive jump every time it actually does that. Let's bring the gain up a bit. And you see how this now is growing with the beat. It's not a continuous motion, it's going literally with the beat. This can be extremely useful. Alternatively, then you can use this minus little button here, which is the same as the plus, but it'll go in reverse. If I click that, it goes backwards. Again, very useful. So to finish off, another trick that you can use in conjunction with all these techniques that I've been showing is to use envelopes. Envelopes are extremely handy for God knows how many uses within Resolume. I've got a whole tutorial on envelopes. So I recommend that you watch that if you're not familiar with them, because they open up a lot of possibilities that are not immediately obvious from looking at the interface. So if we've got this thing that we've just created, let's click our audio, bring that back to the plus. So we've got this going here, but if we were to add an envelope to that, let's say we can attach, let's just do a peaks. You see, we've instantly changed the actual motion that is happening when we have that plus setting. You can manipulate this envelope to your heart's content to achieve all kinds of different animations and effects. So that's it for now. I hope you've learned some tricks and some techniques that you can use when you're using FFT within Resolume. Using FFT really opens up the creative possibilities that Resolume offers, and it frees you from having to do certain tasks so you can concentrate on others, making your performance a lot more engaging. As always, please like and subscribe. It costs you nothing and really does help my channel, and it enables me to carry on doing all these tutorials. Hope to see you here next time.